Hey everybody, it's Midnight Blue Dragon here, and we are continuing the quarry with chapter 9, I think. Pretty much kind of just took a nap. Feel a lot better. And I got me some gold peak tea. Pretty good stuff. It's got that cane sugar in it. You can like get it at your local Walmart. That's where I get my Walmart. Usually buy like the big jug. Hope you all are having a good day today, wherever you may be, and let's continue the story of the quarry.
We can't just sit here.
Why not? Dylan said it's safe here.
Yeah, I don't want to be waiting around.
But that's literally all we need to do. Just wait until morning, right?
Fine. But we need protection. Go see what you can find.
The condoms?
It's better protection? Than just sitting around.
Abigail's pretty cute. She's got a cute face. I like her style. She's a lot more level-headed than Emma. Emma's got a weird mouth. Her mouth is too wide. Ooh, we found the card already. Sweet! Ooh, got a couple of spectrum. Yeah, Abigail. She's a cutie. She seems to be a girl that would like play video games with you all day. You know what I mean? Like she'll be.
Hope it holds. Down.
What'd she say? Yeah, she seems like she'd be a gamer. Okay, I guess we came down here. I'm kind of like figuring out where we're at with Abigail and Emma. I mean, I knew she ran off when what's his name got hurt by that creature, that werewolf. But that's because I made her run off. Surveillance room is missing.
Huh.
Looks like the main fuse is gone.
That's why there's no power? Why would somebody do that?
What is it?
Silver shells.
How'd they get down here?
The hunter must have dropped them. This is probably how he got upstairs and attacked Caitlin.
These fucking guys are everywhere.
Yeah, of all the chicas, I would say Abigail. She's kind of ditzy too. Now I know where we're at. This leads to the dude's office.
What'd you find?
Oh, I'm just checking out this ladder.
Is that a tiny little door up there?
Yeah, it's for tiny little people. Yeah.
We'll open it up.
Okay, you bossy bitch.
We don't know what's up there.
Exactly.
Have you not been paying attention, like, at all?
Okay, what I mean is, it might be good for us to have an escape route. You know, we don't know what's up there. The lodge, there also could be a way for us to defend ourselves.
Okay. Guess that makes sense.
Does she not know how to use a ladder?
You all right?
Damn, I forget how much you weigh.
Okay, that was close.
Man, I know she got some bakery back there, but damn. I don't know, just took the door closing on her. It's pretty funny. Kind of. Ooh, look at that moon. Beautiful.
Oh, they ain't getting through there in a hurry. Man, this place is huge.
That's what she said.
I need to rest a bit.
It's not too late. I can still bite you.
Sorry to disappoint, but the answer is still no.
Oh, don't you worry about me. I'll be fine. I'm good, actually.
What are you doing? Stop it.
Do you smell that?
No.
Sorry, I farted.
Stop it. Never mind. Let's just find another way down. A way to Chris Hackett.
Or just a way out, maybe. I'm done being chased and stabbed.
Sure. And another way out. Fine.
So, between all the girls, Laura. Damn, syringe for days.
What's that?
Proof we're on the right track. Stay close.
Yeah, all the better to see you with, my dear.
Shh.
Laura seems to be the badass. You know what I mean? She kicks ass and takes names. Yeah, this chick. She seems to be the badass. She's definitely a fighter, that's for sure. Abigail's kind of the ditzy, artsy. You know, she'll team up with you, but you gotta watch her. Emma seems like she will only team up with you if it benefits her. She seems like the kind of girl that will leave you when danger hits. Well, what is that? The creature's right there! Hello?
What was that?
I think.
Oh, he's trapped.
I think we found Chris Hackett.
Let's pack him up.
Son of a bitch.
Are you kidding me?
Thank you.
Thanks. For, not killing me.
Yeah. Likewise.
So, what now? Everyone's back to normal?
What? Oh. You think this is over? This isn't over.
Watch out for that gun.
You know I can't let you go.
Grab it, Laura. Grab it. No! Come on! Bullshit, the stupid stick! I pushed up and... Fucking stick. It slightly went to the other way. She's in her underwear and blouse.
To wipe out that wretched family, and you failed. Doesn't matter. There's still time. We can still come out on top. Past is the past. Let's just look to the future, shall we?
Sure.
The sun. The vitality of a new day. There's still time to wake up to the warmth of a night survived. Your choices, your actions, your very life hangs in the balance. It's up to you to find your path in the darkness and see the sun rise once again. Judgment. Judgment Day is upon us. That's what you'd expect from this card, isn't it? Though perhaps in this case, it's simpler than that. Perhaps one's own judgment, a snap decision to make, can save them from their own personal day of reckoning. Every step matters, every decision tipping the balance, one way or the other. Take your time, think, and maybe survive. Hierophant. Where did you find this? Where did you find it? This shouldn't be here. He's been through enough pain. No, no, no. My poor boy. You see what that did to us?
She's part of the family. 6 years ago, Elsa.
No. What have they done? What have they done?
Toasty. Amazing dog boy. See less than amazing dog boy.
Oh.
Kaboom! Everybody's blood on their
Mommy's
face.
Coming, Silas. Mommy's coming, Silas! Silas! Silas!
Traveling circus. Isn't that what they're called? Hey, there's all the Pokemon cards. No wonder I can't find them all, because most of them are burnt.
No. My poor boy. You see what they did to us? How they hurt us. He's out there still, all alone. Each full moon, they hunt him, armed with silver, trying to put an end to a curse they inflicted upon themselves when they set my show ablaze 6 years ago. Stupid children. Little Silas. My little white wolf. He must be protected. He must not follow this path. Do you understand? Remember how I've helped you all this time. Remember how much I've done for you.
I don't know. Something tells me she's going to turn on me. She didn't really help me. You know what I mean? She just yelled at me when I couldn't find those Pokemon cards. What the hell is that guy?
Oh, fuck!
Is that Max? Okay,
I'm on
Max.
Top of a fucking tree! Laura!
Blood. How the hell am I gonna get down?
That way. Apparently you weigh a lot.
Gotta find Laura.
She's got one of the chick's clothes. funny. I mean, it's better than walking around in your underwear, right?
Totally should have just gone to the Harbinger Motel.
Nice walk in the woods late at night. Nothing spooky about this.
She must have come back.
Why does it have an extra hole? Or is that just, is it just torn? Let's swim, because I'm tired of this area.
Okay. This better have a great fucking ending.
What the hell, are you serious? Well, so much for that ending, right? Fucker died as soon as he fucking hit dock. Damn, I should have stayed.
The table, help me.
Get much worse than it already is, right?
Great. Thundercats, ho!
Just like the cartoons.
It's been off and on all night. Gives us a little time.
How do you figure?
They don't like water, remember?
Right. Oh. Damn. We should have just been swimming in the lake all night.
And die of hypothermia? No.
All right, well, we're good now.
Night's not over yet. These fuckers know we're in here, and they're coming back first chance they get.
Great news. Okay.
All right. We gotta get a vantage point.
Okay, so how many werewolves are there? Apparently Max was one, but he died because of that werewolf in the dock. Chris Hatchett was one, but we killed him. Laura's one, but she's locked up. So then who's this one on the dock? The one that killed Max. Who else got bit or scratched? Hmm. And then this chick, she's not too bad. These characters, they kind of grow on you. I know in the beginning of the game, I didn't like any of them. Oh shit, it's Yogi Bear. Oh no, it's Smokey the Bear. Oh, what? We had food here the whole time? Oh wait, they're empty. What is that? Is that spaghetti? Oh, no, it's not what it was. Fancy. I like that fireplace. Look for any Pokemon cards, dude. I guess we go upstairs. What we got here? Got a family album. That baby's got a big forehead. Good grief. I think it'd headbutt you. Oh, he definitely gets it from the father. That's where he got his forehead from. It's the big forehead family. It's a raccoon. From the Raccoon Federation. Dog tags.
Nice to put a name to a big mean face. So what, you're like Mr. H's brother, I guess?
Who?
The big dude from earlier, when you and Ryan went to the radio hut. Mr. H's brother, I guess?
Right.
Oh, the big dude with the baseball cap and the overalls. Well, of course they're all related. That's not a shocker. This better be cheat codes.
Jeez, MC really struggling if they're begging for a dollar.
Hey, I want to read it. There's nothing wrong with raising your prices if you need it to keep that place going. I mean, shit, look at the price of fucking milk and soda through the roof. Out of my way, chump. Man, they need to clear this out and, like, make it, I don't know, just a place you could read, cozy place you could read books and stuff. Ooh, found a Pokemon card. Didn't look like a good one. I'm all you, chump. Okay, I think that's it. Yeah, people don't mind raising, when prices get raised for like a good cause. Like for example, this place, since he's raising prices 5%. As long as that money's being used for, you know, the camp, people don't mind that. It's when, like, the director comes back with the damn Ferrari, and it's like, what the fuck? Now we know where all the extra money went. Definitely didn't go to this place.
A long time ago. Long enough ago that it was okay to have an oil painting made of yourself.
I kind of want an oil painting of me now.
It's the big-headed family. I mean, the big forehead. Keep looking, prepare for attack. Excuse me. What? What do you mean attack?
Every dusk and dawn all through the summer. What doesn't kill you'll make you stronger. We're here to lead the way. That mates for life, we're proud to say. Shout it, Stratton, shout out loud. We're hacketeers. 2 months and you never learn the words?
Oh no, here comes the cavalry.
Showtime, motherfuckers.
Who's that? Oh, it's Jacob. Excuse me.
Fuck this whole night.
Did I get bit? Did Jacob get bit? I don't think so.
I just wish I could tell you I'm sorry. More than anything. Fuck. I just wanted one more night together. Is that too much to ask for? Shit. Stop.
Yeah, he just wanted his dick wet. Baby. Little hanky panky didn't hurt anyone. Okay, so most of the family's dead. The camp family. The counselors. The only one that died so far is
what is going
Max.
On out there? Should we go find the others?
No! We're safer in here and it's nearly morning.
Yeah, I agree. Stay put. Okay, we know it's what coming the? Through the chimney, so let's get the fuck out. It goes to the head. And it's not very smart. Okay, come on, let's get a move on. Standing there, it's not gonna do anything, it's gonna come straight for you. Wait, run, fuck, run! Yeah, it's gonna break through that door in seconds. Come on, quit playing. Keep running.
gotta let her in.
Well, we can't. The office door's locked from the outside.
But there must be something we can do.
Yeah, but what?
Oh shit, they both went separate ways. You went into the room, Caitlin went upstairs.
Silver shells. If we can time it right, we can give them to her if she passes. If she passes.
Shit, 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 shit. Beam! Because the window, won't I just like fall down? And, like break a leg or some shit?
Come on.
There we go. Come on, she's a girl, she's got good balance. She's probably the gymnastics. Come on! Oh shit, it's got good balance too! Ah, what a loser! Dude, should have taken gymnastics like her. With the balance beam champ. Keep on running. Run, run, run.
Caitlin!
This way!
Okay, come on, let's go. Move. Move. Now we do have time for that. Come on. What are you doing? No. Go. Come on. Investigate.
It's Silver!
Sweet!
Hey, I'm here!
To load it. Load it in your gun. Got him in the wiener. Let's turn back. We're gonna find out who this one is.
Fuck you! I got you, motherfucker.
Aren't you gonna turn back to your human form? Yeah, good job, Mr. Frying Pan. I wouldn't get too close. There's always a jump scare.
You got it?
Yeah.
Okay, now let's quit standing there. Well, we're back. And I got a Pokemon card.
The curse is broken. Whatever the cost, whatever darkness from the night still remains, the future, at least, is now a little brighter. What happened to this family they brought upon themselves? And you shouldn't pity them. I knew I could rely on you. I knew that if orchestrated properly, the events of Hackett's Quarry would unfold just the way I wanted them to. And now, well, I suppose...
attack leaves several dead. What do you make of that,
Anton? I love that term, several. Like, the detectives are just, they don't even count the bodies. They're not like one, two, they're like one, two, three. Yeah, you know what? It's several. Several murders.
You know, it might be a tactic, though. They can't give out that information yet. Sometimes detectives are notoriously difficult to solicit information from, especially when you go in saying, hi, I'm a paranormal expert.
I thought we'd done the whole Hackett's Quarry thing.
Not this Hackett's Quarry thing.
What was this, like 3 months ago? Old news, dude.
Anton, introductions first. We are Bizarre Yet Bonafide, the podcast of the paranormal. I'm Grace.
And I'm Anton.
And together, we explore the possibility of supernatural involvement in real life, everyday occurrences.
And that's exactly what they are, real life everyday occurrences.
With a shadow of spiritual supernatural occurrences.
No.
Okay, so I hope you've got hat insurance, Anton, because I'm about to blow your mind.
Did you just ask if I had hat insurance?
Yes, it's responsible to insure those things which mean the most to you.
A hat.
Yes.
Okay, I know where your priorities lie. Go on.
Anyway, there actually is a real reason that we're coming back to Hackett's Quarry. There've been some developments, and I've sourced some information.
I remain skeptical, but I'm all ears. Under my hat.
I was hoping you'd say that.
Oh, God, why? Why are you smiling? Stop it, I hate it.
Why? I had braces. I have to make use of them sometimes.
You do have very pretty teeth.
Thank you. That's something that a lot of podcast listeners might not know about me. So, it just so happens I've got someone on the inside, so today's episode is going to have a bit of a show-and-tell vibe to it.
Who do you know on the inside? The inside of where?
What?
You know someone on the inside?
Don't we all have someone on the inside? You know, an inner critic that says, stop doing a podcast, no one's listening.
You should listen to that voice, Grace.
Okay, well, what I really meant is, let's call it an anonymous donation. You know, we're not the only ones who flagged this as a bizarre situation. Someone actually reached out to us. They sent us a package.
Did you? You didn't open it. I don't trust anyone who listens to this show.
Oh, I couldn't wait to open it. Surprise!
Anonymous donation?
Okay, you've always promised me since day one of this podcast that if you could see true evidence, you will consider all options, right? Did you not say that?
I did say that, yes.
I mean, I know you...
Knowing for a fact that we would never see any evidence, I did say that.
Okay, well, we've been sent information, and we need to decide whether it's bizarre or bona fide.
Okay, fine. Let's do this. For anyone listening at home, we are about to open a package from a mysterious person who listens to this show. If you are the one who sent us whatever it is, congrats, you got us.
Sorry, the tape is just really...
Open the package already.
So much tape on the package. Sorry, can you help me with this? Do you have like a key I could like slice at it with?
No, I don't want you to dull my key. Just use your fingers.
But just give me your fucking key, Anton.
No.
Give me your fucking key.
No. Get your own key.
It's not like you lock your door.
Of course I lock my door.
What are you hiding?
What am I hiding? Do you not lock your doors?
No, I have nothing to hide.
You think that ghosts are real, but you don't lock your doors?
No, ghosts couldn't open my doors. They could walk through my walls, Anton.
Okay, you need to be more concerned with murderers.
Take a look. Apparently, they found another body.
Whoa! You can't just show me a picture of a dead body. You got to tell me before you're going to do that.
Okay, then let's take this over. Anton, can I show you a picture of a dead body?
No!
I can't work with that, Anton.
Okay, fine, yes. It's a dead body. Okay, what is this? What am I looking at?
It's one of the hikers that went missing. Do you remember that?
Yes, that's the true part of the story.
Yeah, Ed Benson was his name. He was drowned in the lake.
Okay, drowned or was drowned?
Now you're getting grammatical.
I'm not getting grammatical. If you drown, you just went swimming and you drowned. If he's been drowned, then someone drowned him.
Well, then I think I implied precisely what I meant to imply. Now, of course, I can't verify this info, but...
Of course you can't.
What, do I have, like, a history of not verifying
this
info?
Yes, it's fake.
Okay, but I feel very strongly that he was drowned.
Okay, well, do the police know about this? Are the Hackett family suspects?
Okay,
Okay, I like that you are getting into this. Here's the thing. The newspaper says this guy's still missing, right? He looks pretty fucking found in this picture.
Okay, yeah, I mean, he's not missing, he's right there, but
yeah.
Why? Why would they say he's still missing?
Because it is a conspiracy! A cover-up! Don't you see? They're all in on it.
Who's all in on it? The Hackett family?
The Hackett family, the North Kill Gazette. I told you I've been suspicious of them from the start.
Okay, so there's the one hiker, he's dead. What about the other one?
Anne Radcliffe? Still missing. Who knows how many bodies are still down there, though.
I don't know. This is pretty inconclusive. I'm sorry that the guy drowned, but this kind of seems like a big to-do over nothing.
Or is it a big undo of something, which is what a cover-up is?
Okay, you can't just twist my words like that.
Okay, so I anticipated your skepticism, which is why I saved this little gem for next.
Finally, you're gonna present me with some ghost ectoplasm.
Put out your ring finger. I've got a little gem to slide onto it.
What do you got?
Leaked photos from the hiker's camera. Photos that show them at Hackett's quarry.
So, maybe they were there and then they dropped their camera. It happens all the time.
Yeah, they dropped their camera whilst being murdered. And their bags were found there too.
Oh, no way. Do you have a fake photo of them too?
Oh, please.
Okay, so you have a picture of bags. These could be anyone's bags.
Well, they match up to the ones in their photos from their camera, and they have a monogram of their initials. I think, at least. Or it's water damage, I can't tell.
Yeah, okay. That's not nothing, I'll give you that.
So, we've got to talk a little more about the Hackett family.
Right, so these guys are like the heritage landowners, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Their great-great-great-grandparents were trappers who claimed the land way back when.
They just claimed it?
Yes, they did. They put their flag on it just like the man on the moon.
The Hackett family flag, right.
Well, apparently when they claimed it, they found quartzite.
Quartzite?
Okay, I was hoping you would ask. Fun fact, every building in the whole of New York is made of quartzite.
That's not fun or a fact.
Most of them are, but I digest.
Digress?
It was a pun. They dug the quarry and hit great heights of success before Septimus Hackett, classic bad guy name, the seventh son of the trappers, the number seven, has great supernatural powers, closed the mine down.
Okay, so then they only had the land to live off.
Yes, you say only, but this land actually spans acres. That's a lot of forest, a lot of unexplored darkness.
Ooh, okay, a great place to hide, to have all these dark secrets for this strange, reclusive family.
Mm-hmm. And this is where we start to get a little more into paranormal territory.
Okay, here we go.
Acres and acres of haunted woods.
If you say so.
Next, we have this empty vial thing.
Okay, the way you say empty vial makes me think that there was something creepy in there before.
Well, it's not half full, you little optimist, okay? We've got a photo from whoever my supernatural fairy godmother may be, but what are your initial thoughts?
Your godmother sends you vials full of this. I mean, it looks like there could have been blood in here.
My fairy godmother, not my actual godmother. She's estranged.
My God, what did she do?
It's actually what I did. But the important thing is, look at this vial and tell me it does not scream nefarious ritual.
Yeah, I mean, it seems like it could have had blood in it.
Yeah, something about this doesn't look like anything normal.
Yeah, well, it's a vial full of fucking blood.
Okay, but putting the Hackett family aside for a moment, there's more to this. Are you ready for some real spooky shit?
I'm ready for real spooky shit. I don't know if you can provide it, but please try.
Don't get too freaked out.
I'll try my hardest.
Okay, do you want to hold my hand?
No.
Okay, do you need someone to comfortingly pat your back?
Please just say what you're gonna say.
Do you want me to turn all the lights on so you don't
I don't want you to do anything. I want you to say what you have.
Actually, you might be a little freaked out at this.
Ugh, is that skin?
Skin, fur, whatever you want to call it, really.
It looks human.
Hmm.
Wait, is it?
Apparently, it belongs to whatever creature supposedly caused all this.
Do we have the actual thing? Can I see it in the flesh, so to speak?
No, just the photo. Whoever got in touch was smart enough to not risk actually stealing evidence.
Convenient that we can't see the real deal, huh?
Come on, man.
Just saying.
So this next thing to me isn't overtly supernatural, but it'd be unfair not to discuss it.
Okay, so far I wouldn't describe any of it as overtly supernatural, but sure, let's do this.
Claw marks.
Wow. You're right. That is underwhelming.
But I'm kind of interested because whoever did reach out thought it was worth sharing.
Grace, it's highly likely this is all just an elaborate prank.
True. But if I treated everything like that, then I wouldn't have a job.
Eh, fair point, I guess. So, what we've got here, this could incriminate the Hackett family, or what's left of them, at least.
Wait, you believe it?
I don't know. At the very least, we should... tell someone. The police should know, right?
So you believe it? All of it?
No, not the supernatural stuff. I'm talking about killing those hikers. We've got a body, evidence they were there. This is real stuff, Grace. It's stacking up against the Hacketts. We might know something.
We got a whole flapjack stack of evidence.
Yes!
So what do we do?
Shut off the podcast and report this to somebody?
What? No! Anton, we finally have something going here. It's getting juicy.
Yes, we have something real. Actual people have actually died. This is actually crazy. Grace, you did it. Just take the win. Let's turn this off and actually report it.
No, say actually more.
Ass.
Okay, so we finished another game on Twitch. So once in a blue moon, I do tend to finish my games. Great game. I definitely did like it. The characters had to grow on me. The only one I liked off the bat was probably Abigail. Definitely will play this again. But I'll play it through one sitting, because it's definitely a game you could beat in one day. Because I want to do a lot better. Great game. When did this game come out? I don't, not that while, just a while ago, not that long ago. Let me see, let me Google it. There we go, that's better. Okay, this game came out June 10th, 2022. Okay, so past this past summer. Say, can you dig? Can you dig what I found? Yeah. Great game. Definitely could have got it right off when it came out, but I was playing other games. You know, these games are just like the anthology games. What? Can we speed this up? I don't want to like... I want to let the whole thing go and maybe something else happens. Can you speed this up? Let me see. Above the law. Travis is above the law. The video, nasty. The video, hasty. I don't know what the little word is. A dollar. Rewind, please. Does this look like the goddamn Harbinger Motel? Oh, I like these. A fool's errand. A film by Martin Clemens. Please rewind down the rabbit hole. Be careful what you find. Oh, these are pretty cool. Playing with fire. Watch your step. Some pieces of silver. Finders keepers. Distraction. The White Whale. Team building. A pound of flesh. Huh. Wow, we almost found all of them. I don't even know how we did that. But we only need 3 more. Interesting. Definitely got most of the evidence. Just need 3 more. We got our little birdie. We didn't find a lot of the Pokemon cards, the tarot cards. You unlock the Death Rewind feature. This feature allows you 3 opportunities within a single playthrough of the Quarry to reverse a playable character's death and try again to save them. Use your 3 lives wisely. Sweet! Yeah, you can enable or disable the Death Rewind feature via the accessibility section of the settings menu at any time. Nice! Nice. Pretty good. Good game. Alright guys, we're going to go ahead and end this gameplay of the Quarry. Definitely want to play it again. Just through one sit through. I like it. I like these kind of games. You know, it's movie, video game kind of thing. I know they're not everybody's cup of tea, but they're definitely mine. I mean, I definitely like the first time I played these games, these kind of games, was one for the PS4. What's it called? Let me see, do I have it over here? I think I do. Let me check. No. I'm pretty sure I have it here. Inside Dawn? Is that one? That one? That's called? Let me check. I know it's here somewhere. Let's see. Night Trap is kind of like that. Kind of. Do I not have it? I don't know. Let's see. Yakuza, Bloodstained, Fallout 4, Tekken 7, Bloodborne. Days Gone. Maybe I don't have an actual physical copy of it. I thought I did. Because I have a digital copy. Huh. Inside Dawn, I think that's what it's called. Yeah. And then the whole anthology games are very similar. And they're good games. And then now this one. Alright. I think this is gonna do it for this game. Hope you all are having a good day today. Remember, you're the main character in your life. So, don't forget to go level up. Until next time, thank you for watching. Bye.